Now at 6, the Roman Catholic Diocese of Springfield released findings of an investigation into a sexual abuse allegation against late Bishop Christopher Weldon. Western Mass News reporter Leon Purvis is live in Springfield with more. Leon?
Sarah, last July, the diocese asked retired Judge Peter Vilas to lead an independent investigation on the allegations against the late Bishop Weldon. Now, Bishop Mitchell Rozanski and Judge Vilas in a news conference today discussed the findings and what's next. Vilas says he found the diocese investigation into the complaint against the late bishop was greatly flawed, but his conclusions were clear.
I came to the conclusion and stand behind it as strongly as I did when I first made it to this moment. And that is that these accusations were unequivocally credible.
I want to sincerely apologize to this victim, not just for the terrible abuse that he had to endure as a young child, abuse which still haunts him to this very day. But I want to apologize for the chronic mishandling of this case time and time again since 2014.
Bishop Rozanski went on to announce the following changes: that Bishop Weldon's name be removed from the Trinity Health Rehab Building, his remains removed from a diocesan cemetery to a less prominent location with simple marker. Also remove all honorable mentions, references, memorials, and pictures of him from all Catholic facilities, and place his name on the diocesan's website listing with credible allegations of sex abuse. Trinity Health telling us tonight that it's clear the Weldon Rehabilitation Hospital must be renamed, and they will act on that immediately. A new name has not yet been determined. Live in Springfield, Leon Purvis, Western Mass News.